Welcome to Rely Local Frederick Business Radio Spotlight. For the next 30 minutes, you will hear fast-paced interviews, unique perspectives, and valuable insight from real people who believe that empowering local business is everybody's business. This show is about the backbone of America, small businesses right here in and around the communities where we live, work, and play. And now, your host, Caressa Flannery, brings you Rely Local Frederick's Business Radio Spotlight.
Hello there. This is Caressa Flannery, your host today for the Rely Local Business Spotlight. And I'm sure a lot of people out there are wondering, what is Rely Local? Well, a healthy community depends on a healthy economy, and both completely depend on the local businesses in Frederick. Simply put, more money spent with local businesses stays here, roughly about 68%, where much less money spent with national chains stays in the area, only about 14%. And money that you spend online, well, that simply leaves us forever. And to us here at Rely Local, supporting local businesses doesn't stop with the economy. It is all about creating a stable and vibrant community. Frederick businesses create jobs, the tax revenue for schools, parks, roads, while offering diversity in the marketplace with unique products and services that you can't find in the big box stores or chain restaurants. Not to mention, these local businesses are owned by the very people who sponsor our little leagues, they donate to our local charities, and they volunteer for our community events. They give back to the community in countless ways. You rely on them, but can they rely on you? And did you know that every dollar that you spend with a Frederick business stimulates the local economy? That's right. You don't have to break the piggy bank to support local businesses. If you just refocus about $20 of your current spending toward local businesses versus online, national, or big box merchants, you can make a major impact in our community. And folks, today we are here with a local business owner, a member of Rely Local Frederick. And Gwen, we are really happy to have you here with Glade Link Farms. So we're going to talk all about fruits and veggies and good stuff happening at the farm today. So welcome.
Good morning, Caressa. Thank you for having us.
Absolutely. So I think what we'll do to start off is we want to tell people a little bit about Glade Link Farms, you know, how your family got started in the business, and just, you know, give us a little bit of the background, if you will, with Glade Link Farms.
Glade Link Farms, this year will be our 42nd year in business.
Wow.
It was started by our parents 42 years ago, strictly as a pick-your-own strawberry operation. Mm-hmm. Over the years, we've expanded to strawberries and pick-your-own blueberries and blackberries we take to the farmer's market. We also have a lot of cut flowers that we take to the market and do for special events. And then finally, in the fall, we wrap it up with a large pick-your-own pumpkin patch, as well as fall vegetables and decorations.
Wow. Yeah. So there's a lot of stuff happening and a lot of stuff growing and whatnot. And I imagine you're probably prepping for a big season coming up.
We are. Currently, we're getting ready for our strawberry season.
Woohoo.
That can be as little as 3 to 4 weeks away, believe it or not, even with the chill in the air. We spend a lot of time making sure that those blossoms stay safe and become berries for you when you come out to the farm to pick.
Right.
Which means we're up all night long checking the temperatures, and if it gets too cold, we have to turn on water to freeze over those blossoms so that right. It will protect them.
So you pretty much start with the strawberries, I guess, you know, so you're prepping for that, and you said it's a few weeks.
It's about 3 to 4 weeks, and then immediately after that, we go right into the blueberry season.
Okay, you go into blueberries. And then all the while, do you have a variety of your veggies and pumpkins growing and so forth?
Yeah, we have several vegetables that we grow in the spring also. We've already mm-hmm. planted spinach and beets and awesome. Sugar snap peas that will be available during strawberry season.
Great.
Throughout the summer, we also go to the farmers markets in Frederick on East Street as well as Bachman's Lane. And we take the strawberries and the blueberries and the vegetables and lots of cut flowers to the market.
Great. So tell us a little bit about the pick-your-own fruit, because this is a unique aspect to Glade Link Farms. And, I mean, I'm not sure in other communities and other areas if there are a lot of the pick-your-own fruit farms. Maybe there are. I'm not familiar with that myself. But tell us a little bit about that process and how if somebody wants to go to the farm to pick their own strawberries, you know, to make pies or whatever they're doing, what do they do?
Well, the first thing they do is they would call our hotline number, which is 301-898-7131. And on that hotline, we give you all the information about what's in season, what the location is, the price, and what our hours are. And that number we change immediately if something changes during the day, such as weather. Then they would come to the farm, and usually our customers bring their own containers, and they would check in at our check-in stand. Mm-hmm. We take the weight of their containers so they don't pay for that on the way out.
Right.
And then we take them out into the field.
It's kind of like when you go to the landfill, you know, they do your weight before and after.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's awesome.
And we show them a place to pick, mm-hmm. and the reason we do that is so that that day, they're the only ones that have picked there.
Gotcha.
They're getting, you know, the ones
the
that are right,
the
freshest,
yeah.
and
yeah.
nobody else has, you know, picked over them before them. Mm-hmm. That's kind of unique to our business. A lot of places are pick your own, but they just say go out to the field.
Just have at it.
Yeah. And that's
just, here's the field.
Not real productive yeah. as far as time goes. And
well, sure, but you want people to have a good experience too, I think.
And, exactly.
You know, obviously, to get the ripest, the most fresh, you know, strawberries, they're going to be like, wow, these are great. I'm going to come back here again and again. And that's the whole idea, I think.
That's right. And again, we've seen over the years, parents bring their children,
yeah.
bring their grandchildren. We've seen the generations come back, and that's what we strive to do. We always allow people to bring their children mm-hmm. along with them so that they can experience the process of picking, knowing how
right.
things grow, not just going to the grocery store and picking up something that's coming from
Well, they
Who
get to learn
where.
A little bit about agriculture, how things, you know, they're grown on, you know, in farms, how they make it to the grocery store, basically.
Yeah, they actually, yeah, they do, because
there's an education
a lot of kids
process.
Have
yeah.
no idea where their food comes from.
Right.
Even adults sometimes. So, you know, we teach them that maybe not standing there lecturing them, but by showing
exactly.
them.
Well, do you ever get classrooms, you know, school teachers bringing out some students here and there?
We Might used to have a lot of that with the cutbacks and all the things in the
yeah.
school. They don't do too many field trips anymore.
Gotcha.
We do, however, have some, like the Y would bring out a group in the summer sometimes, and they
sure.
would contact us first so we know they were coming, and we'd
right.
give them suggestions on how they could handle, you know, purchasing and what they should expect from the kids. And
right.
How the process works.
Yeah, I think it's a great opportunity. I mean, not only are they getting, you know, fresh, healthy food, but they're also learning a little bit about agriculture. And, of course, Frederick County is huge with agriculture, so certainly rich with knowledge and the ability to be able to learn that whole process. So it's great that you all are providing that ability, if need be, for whatever groups might want it. So, okay, so you mentioned the strawberries and the blueberries, and, you know, we've talked a little bit about, you know, the vegetables, and you mentioned what you have, you know, as far as in the spring and whatnot. But I think when we come back from this first break that we're going to have here shortly, maybe we'll talk a little bit about some of the things that you have coming down the pike as far as the specific vegetables and stuff, so people can think ahead and, you know, contact Glade Link Farms for some of those goodies later on. Okay, folks, we're heading into a break. We will be back with Gwen here shortly. But don't forget, from Gettysburg to Brunswick and Hagerstown to Mount Airy, may the source be with you. This is Caressa Flannery. We'll be right back.
Hi, my name is Brent, and I'm the general manager at Roddy Creek Automotive, and I want to personally invite you to our new full-service automotive facility located on Route 15 just north of Thurmont on Roddy Creek Road. Our objective is to give you the best car care and customer service that you have ever experienced. Roddy Creek Automotive has a professional staff of ASE-certified mechanics who will put you and your car's performance first. We specialize in personal service, and we will pick up and drop off your vehicle at any prearranged location to get the first-class service that you deserve.
This week only, during the G8 Summit, stop by and mention G8, and we'll give you $8 off. Is your computer slow?
Then it should be going to Tech Junkies.
Tech Junkies will diagnose the issues and transform your system into a top-performing pro. And they can custom-build you an entirely new one. Ask Tech Junkies about their remote services.
They can take over your system and do all the cleanups, defrags, and other diagnostics to save you time.
And their talented website design staff can create a beautiful site for your personal or business use. Check them out at techjunkies.com.
That's TECJunkies.com.
We left out the H because we left out the hype. Or call 240-288-8126.
Hello, we are back. This is Caressa Flannery, your host for the Rely Local Business Spotlight. And I just want to remind folks out there, you know, we do these spotlights with local business owners in the Frederick County area, and we would love to hear your feedback. So if you'd like to email us any feedback or questions or even interview suggestions that you are interested in passing along, you can do so by sending that email to rlf@wthu.org, or you can call the station at 301-637-6736. And we are back with Gwen Whitmore. She is one of the owners of Glade Link Farms, and it is a family farm that has been in Frederick County for 42 years. Good golly.
It's a long time.
Yes, it is a long time. I can't even imagine. So when we were talking before, you know, we kind of went into, you know, the pick your own fruits and some of the things, you know, unique features that you have there at the farm. And we talked a little bit about some of the vegetables and things coming down the pike. But let's share with our listeners out there, you know, when you have some of these other vegetables available, when they can expect to find pumpkins at the farm, you know, some of those types of things. So they can get out their calendars right now if they want and throw some of that stuff into it. So tell us a little bit.
Okay, Caressa. As I said before, in the spring during the strawberries, we will have spinach, mm-hmm. we will have sugar snap peas, and we will have beets.
Yes.
During the blueberry season, it's basically blueberries. And blueberry season comes in right after strawberries around the last week of June.
Okay.
We kind of take a break at the farm as far as people coming out until around mid-September. Mm-hmm. And then they can get a whole variety of vegetables. We grow broccoli and cauliflower and red and green cabbage.
Wow.
Collards. We have pick-your-own green beans. We have kale, turnips, and a lot of winter squash, as well as a lot of decorative items besides
like the
pumpkins.
Gourds
the gourds and the corn stalks and that kind of thing.
And that preps them for the Halloween, the Thanksgiving seasons.
It takes them
on into
some the people have even taken up over Christmas. They've taken pumpkins and painted them silver or gold and decorated with those. So,
Absolutely. That's great. And I imagine there's probably a process involved there, just like, you know, the pick your own for individuals who want to go out to the farm, similar type of thing, I would imagine. And then what about also restaurants and grocery stores? I know that you do some, you know, wholesaling and distribution to those as well.
We do some wholesaling to several restaurants and several grocery stores. The best way to contact us for that would be to get on our website and go to the contact portion and put in your information and what you're looking for.
Right.
Then we would get back with you in a phone call and see if we can work out all the logistics of it, whether you were going to come to the farm and pick it up or we could deliver it to you.
Yeah.
We're kind of a small operation, so we don't do a whole lot of delivery.
Right.
But we do have a lot of places that come and pick them up and take them back to their business, and that would be the best way to get a hold of us for that.
Sure. And I imagine that there's so many different restaurants out there with all the buzz out there about healthy eating and, you know, getting into the weight loss and weight management, that I imagine a lot of restaurants are trying to get more fresh vegetables, fresh fruits, you know, locally grown. And of course, you know, a lot of people want to support local. They want to support the local farmers and have homegrown things, I think. And it's great that the restaurants, a lot of the restaurants in the area are taking part in that too.
We've noticed that a lot in Frederick. There's a lot of restaurants that their number one priority is to get local produce.
Yeah.
Sometimes they can get the local produce just by coming to the farmer's market. Because if they're
which is our next question we're going to be talking about. So, yeah,
great.
Tell us all about that.
The farmer's market, we actually go to three of them. Two of them are in Frederick on Thursday afternoons, beginning in the beginning of June through the end of October. We're on East Street from Thursdays from 3 p.m. to 6 p.m. And there we have, you know, pretty much everything we're offering at the farm, other than we don't take the big, large pumpkins out there when the fall comes. We take the smaller things, and we do the fruits, and we do the vegetables, and a lot of flower arrangements we take there. Saturdays, we're out on Balkman's Lane from 10 until 1, and that goes from Mother's Day weekend all the way through the weekend before Thanksgiving, I'm sorry. And the same sort of thing. It's just on a much bigger scale. That's a larger market.
Right.
And then for those of you who have friends who might be out of town, on Sundays we go down to Greenbelt. And those hours are from 10 to 2. And we take the same things down there.
That's
Like I said, some of the chefs in Frederick, they don't need large quantities that, you know, it would not be worthwhile for us to deliver to them. But they come out to the farmer's market on Saturdays or Thursdays, and they see what we have, and then
they can
plan their menus accordingly and pick it up.
That's great. So, well, and it sounds like there's the convenience, you know, obviously with the farmers markets and the people driving along, see, you know, colorful, fresh vegetables and, you know, things at those stands. They're, you know, compelled in some ways to stop.
It draws them in.
Ooh, honey, we need some fresh veggies for tonight's dinner, you know.
It is, and we've seen over the years the combination of adding the markets as well as coming to the farm for the pick-your-own. We have many customers that do both. It just depends on what their time constraints are in a certain day. Lots of times they will say, this week I don't have time, so I'm just going to go to the farmer's market and pick it up.
Yeah.
But the next time they want to put up, you know, lots of stuff for the winter, put in the freezer and can. I might add, too, that if you have questions about that, we are certainly welcome to give you some information or where you can find the information so you can do that yourself.
Sure. Helping people take those fruits and vegetables and incorporate them into their diets and their meals and whatnot.
Exactly.
Yeah, that's great. So you mentioned flowers and all the beautiful florals that you see, you know, at the farmers markets. And I imagine when you go out to the farm, you see lots of beautiful color and whatnot. So tell us a little bit about the florals that you provide or that you grow. And then you also are doing a lot of stuff with weddings, I understand.
We are. We've been growing flowers for almost 20 years now.
Wow.
We started with just sunflowers, and now we've expanded. They're all annual, but they're all your kind of country, colorful, easygoing flowers.
Right.
About 2 years ago, my son got married, and we did our first wedding, which was theirs. So we found out that we felt pretty good at it, and we really enjoyed doing it. We've expanded that, and we've done many weddings since then, small or large. A lot of them are with our own flowers, which that's our preference, but if somebody needs something else added in, we can also
get their specific favorite flower.
We can get those.
Isn't there
even though we don't grow them, we can get them and incorporate that into.
So are you doing the actual bouquets? You're putting them together?
We do everything. We can do the bouquets, the boutonnieres, the corsages, the table decorations for the, you know, for the ceremony. The brides have a lot of different options. They can do some of them, all of them. Some of them want to just buy loose flowers and do their own, which is an option also.
That's great. Well, listen, we'll wrap up with a little bit on the weddings. We're going to take another break here, and we'll be right back. This is Caressa Flannery. We'll be back in a few.
Mr. Hughes hidden Dylan's shoes, wearing his disguise, but it's all right now. Learned my lesson well. See, you can't please everyone, so you got to please yourself. La da da. La da da da.
Image means personality, and businesses, like people, have personalities. The right advertising can make or break you in the marketplace. WETCHCO Signs has what it takes to help you develop that winning image. Call them at 301-378-2216. That number again is 301-378-2216. WETCHCO Signs is a proud sponsor of the champion, Frederick Keys.
Honesty and integrity. Open communication. A team of experts. A proven history of success. Business Management Company Incorporated, a full-service accounting firm, has been serving the region for more than 20 years. BMC offers a full range of accounting services, including monthly books, payroll, accounts payable, professional income tax preparation, business financial consulting, and insurance. We specialize in small businesses. Check out our website at bmcaccounting.com today and watch your business grow.
Liberty Tax Service is open year-round and can help you with a wide range of tax-related services. Let Liberty Tax Service in Walkersville help you now. Individuals, small businesses, and students, we can help you file fast and accurately. Liberty Tax Service has years of experience preparing your taxes. Liberty Tax Service is conveniently located at 138 Walkers Village Way in Walkersville. Call them today at 301-845-6707.
Went to a garden party.
Hello again, this is Caressa Flannery, and I want to make sure everyone out there listening knows that they can find the Source Radio Network on Facebook. They also can find Rely Local Frederick, and they can find my guest today, Gwen Whitmore, and her business, Glade Link Farms, is also on Facebook. So get out your PDA phones or get on your iPads or computers and get to Facebook and hook up with all three businesses. You'll learn a lot of information about local businesses on Rely Local as well as the Source Radio Network, and you will get all kinds of great information from Glade Link Farms from their Facebook page as well. So, Gwen, it's great to have you back. We're going to just, anything else? We were talking a little bit about the weddings and the flowers that you guys provide. Anything else you want to discuss having to do with that? Or,
well, we wanted to, I guess, expand a little bit more on what we were going to do in the fall. We are in the process of planning something special for every weekend in October at our
Great.
Pumpkin field. All the plans haven't been finalized, but keep yourself updated by signing up for our email list, mm-hmm. and we will send you...
You've got that email newsletter that you send
exactly.
out that's great, and it gives all kinds of detailed information about things coming up, which is awesome. And one thing I want to point out is you guys are great. You don't jam inboxes with lots of emails.
No, you know, we only send out when it's the important part, and
exactly.
then you know to open it so that it does mean something that you should find out about.
Exactly.
We have already finalized that we will be in Frederick County's Family Festival at the farm.
Okay.
And that's the third weekend in October. We will have all kinds of activities that weekend. We have hay rides, we have scarecrow making, we have pumpkin decorating.
Mm-hmm.
We are going to have another weekend, the second weekend in October, which will be an old-fashioned weekend. And we're planning to have all kinds of old-fashioned games that people don't really play anymore.
Like hopscotch or something?
We might have hopscotch. Yeah. We might have some hula hoops there.
Oh, okay.
There's a bowling game that we're trying to work on, a beanbag toss.
Right.
We're coming up with some good ideas for that. That's still in the works, but we're going to team up that weekend with the Walkersville Food Bank.
And wonderful.
They
so
are
people can donate when they're there.
People can donate when they're going to play the games to the food bank, and the food bank, in turn, is going to give us some help in running the games. So it's a win-win for both of us.
That sounds great. It sounds like you've got a lot of great family-oriented events and things that are going to be happening in the fall, so people can look forward to those things, bring their family out, especially when it's a little cooler and crisp, you know, weather out, you know, start wearing the sweaters again. Of course, we're in the season right now where we want to get rid of the sweaters.
I know. It's we're ready for spring.
I know.
We really are. But we wanted to stress that, you know, we're a family-owned business,
mm-hmm.
and we cater to families,
yes.
and that is our full intent.
Yes. Definitely. No, I think that's great that you all provide all the things that you do. It's such a unique, just the whole farm and everything, you know, throughout the year. You've got stuff going on and things available throughout the year. So that's great for, you know, families to take part in that. Okay, so I know on your website you all have some great information on there. You mentioned earlier that, you know, anytime anybody has any questions about how to prepare something or, you know, use the fruits and vegetables that you have there at the farm, if they need assistance with that. But you've got some things on your website. Maybe you want to just, you know, share a little bit of information about what they can hope to find.
Sure. Our website is pretty extensive. First of all, they can find out when the seasons are. that's always good to know, to keep in mind. We also have a tab on there that says the latest dish. Mm-hmm. And that's for every season that comes by, we change the recipes to use whatever's in season at the time.
Right.
And these recipes are recipes that we've used forever and always good, great comments about.
Oh, so. Yeah, great stuff on there. I mean, I was getting hungry, like, looking at some of that in the past.
You don't have to experiment by looking in the cookbook and hoping that it's going to taste good, because
exactly. It
is tried and true.
Yeah, so that's wonderful. Yeah, there's a lot of good information, I think, that you can provide, you know, whether it be, you know, something like pies. You know, a lot of people think, you know, pies is like dessert. It's, you know, it's fun to have at you know, any kind of dinner engagement or reception or whatever. But, you know, there's so many different healthy recipes that are out there, you know, with some of the things that you provide too. So a lot of people, I imagine, want to get creative and want to eat healthier and want to, you know, have a creative dessert dish or something like that, you know, for a special event that they might be planning. So that's great that you guys provide that information for them. Okay, so are there any other events or things that we need to talk about as far as, you know, what's happening at the farm before we head into, you know, just sharing a little bit of the contact information?
I don't believe there's any other special events. It's just that pretty much every season is an event and every season mm-hmm. is different. We have the customers who hopefully they will come through all the seasons, but there are ones that, you know, strawberry season, that is really a big one because it's one of the first things fresh
yeah.
and local you can get in the spring.
Right.
It's usually still rather cool, and who doesn't like strawberries?
Oh, I know. yeah.
And blueberries.
And they're so good for you.
Exactly.
You know?
And yeah. the blueberries everybody associates with 4th of July, which mm-hmm. that's probably one of the peak times, so it can be your family outing for that morning.
Picnics and all sorts of things, you know,
exactly.
you can definitely enjoy a lot of those berries that they can pick themselves or they can find at the farmers markets, and then heading into, well, I mean, even in the spring you do have the vegetables and a variety of different things for people, so that's wonderful. We talked a little bit about the events and, you know, all the things that are happening. Let's give people all your contact information, how they can get in touch with Glade Link Farms, how they can visit and so forth.
Okay, the most primary thing they want to remember, and this is the most up-to-date information, we always stress that you call this number before you head to the farm, and that would be 301-898-7131. And that's an outgoing recorded message that I will give you all the information you need to know immediately. Mm-hmm. Our website is great also. That gives you, you know, planning ahead. The information, the recipes, you can see pictures so that
beautiful photography, yeah.
you can visualize what you're going to see before you even get
there.
And
the website address is?
And the website address is www.gladelink.com. We're also on Facebook and mm-hmm. Twitter, and we're also going to be putting out coupons on the Rely Local this year.
Mm-hmm.
So watch for those.
Awesome.
You can use those at certain specific times in each season.
Definitely. And they can find you, obviously, on Rely Local. And we'll mention again that you do have an email newsletter, so people can sign up for that, and they get up-to-date information as well through the email. So thank you so much, Gwen, for coming in today. We really appreciate you and Glade Link Farms and everything that you guys are doing in the Frederick community. And folks, that is a wrap for today, but stay tuned for our next program. The Bobby Likas Car Clinic is sponsored by Rely Local member Roddy Creek Automotive. This is Caressa Flannery. We'll talk to you next time.
Thanks for tuning in to Rely Local Frederick's Business Radio Spotlight right here on AM 1450, The Source. Heard Saturdays at 1:30 p.m., Rely Local Frederick's Business Radio Spotlight is a movement, a campaign to take us back to what makes America great. businesses locally owned and operated by you and your neighbors. Thanks for spending your valuable time today with us.